Well, the UN Security Council today called for the perpetrators of the terrorist acts by Boko Haram to be held accountable.
Yeah, the statement today was the strongest by the UN's most powerful body. The council expressed outrage at Boko Haram's abduction of 276 schoolgirls on April 14th and 8 more girls this month and demanded the girls' immediate release. It also condemned the May 5th attack that caused hundreds of deaths and injuries, calling Boko Haram's acts crimes against humanity. Meanwhile, British security experts have now joined American security experts and Nigerian forces trying to rescue those missing students.
And of course, the kidnapping of those schoolgirls has raised up a global outcry. Protesters are flooding social media outlets, calling for more action from governments around the globe and posting signs with the message, "Bring back our girls."
And here at home, dozens took over War Memorial Plaza today in a show of support for those kidnapped schoolgirls in Nigeria.
The rally was organized by the Baltimore Leadership School for Young Women, and it included a moment of silence and a show of solidarity. 11 News reporter Kai Reed joins us live at War Memorial Plaza with that story. Kai.
Well, Donna, many of the people out here this afternoon were Baltimore area students who made signs and spoke in support of the safe return of the Nigerian girls. The group of students and organizers marched from the Baltimore Leadership School for Young Women to War Memorial Plaza, clad in red and holding posters in a show of solidarity.
And I think it shows the world that we care, that we're not going to stand by and watch this happen. And the other thing I think it shows the world is that we're all connected. It's a small world.
We want our girls back home. We want our daughters back home. We want our sisters back home. And we want our friends back home. And we want everyone to help in the world, the whole universe.
They were protesting the kidnapping of nearly 300 schoolgirls in Nigeria. The girls were taken from a boarding school on April 15th. The militant Islamic group Boko Haram has claimed responsibility and said that the girls were taken because of the group's dislike for Western education.
Education is a basic human right, and no one should have the power to take that away. No one should be kidnapped or bought or sold. I demand action.
Demonstrators included private and public students from the city and county, plus a large number of Nigerian Americans like Susan Okuzu, a mother who said that she was moved by the show of support in Baltimore.
It's a world problem that they're women, they're girls, you know, being trained to be women. So it's very important. It shows me that everyone is touched by this, by the act of terror. That's what I call that, that's happened to these girls.
Outrage at this atrocity should not be a passing fad.
Mayor Stephanie Rawlings Blake called for the international community to take immediate action to bring the girls home safely.
We need to add our voices to the voices that are being heard all over the country to say that our girls are valuable and they need to be treated with dignity and respect and not like property, not damaged, not abused, and not stolen from their future.
And there are a lot more of these events planned over the next couple of days. A group will travel from Baltimore to Washington, D.C. tomorrow to rally in front of the Nigerian embassy. Reporting live downtown, Kai Reed, WBAL-TV 11 News.